So I want to give a proof of this formula in the case of a finite Galois extension. Where these U1 and U2 are subgroups of the Galois group. And then we have, so maybe I repeat here, then we get this formula. So let's define, the strategy is very simple. We define the subgroup, which is the Galois group of automorphism fixing the product, so the guy here on the left. And this is obviously subgroup of G, and we claim that this is precisely given by the intersection of U1 and U2. This I'm going to show in a moment, but once we have this, let's assume it for a second, then so we have a Galois extension, we can apply the fundamental theorem of Galois theory. And this says that an intermediate field F between L and K is equal to the RL to the Galois group of RL over F, so to the fixed field of this Galois group. So applying this to the product of L U1. LU2, we have the Galois group is what we defined as U, and assuming the claim, this is precisely L1 of U1 intersected by U2, which is our statement, what we want to prove. So we only need to show Let's prove this identity. Well, on one hand, if I have an automorphism in U, this means that sigma fixes the product LU1 and LU2, and so in particular fixes LU1 alone and LU2 alone. And therefore, it fixes both. In other words, sigma is both an element of U1 and U2. In the other direction, let's consider an automorphism in the intersection here, which therefore fixes both LU1 and LU2. And let's take an element in the product. So I can, the product ring here consists of elements which can be written as, is generated by the product. So I can write these as say A1, B1, finite sum, AN, BN, where AI here are in LU1 and BI are in LU2. So when I apply sigma here, of course, this is additive, so I have the product, and then this is sigma of A1 times sigma of B1, and so on, And since by the assumption of sigma, this is precisely A1. So in the end, this is an element that fixes, this is fixed by sigma. So sigma is indeed an element of U.